As we begin, I open this space by calling on my highest self, your highest self, and all of our angels and guides, our ancestors, and all that is. Muchas gracias a Pachamama. Thank you to Gaia. And thank you for being here. And to Kuyeo Yasin. Hello and welcome to my first collective reading. This reading is in advance of the July 2022 Buck full moon in Capricorn. So we're feeling into what's coming up in your abundance life. How's that abundance vibration? First, I'm going to have you look at these three piles, and then I'm going to apply a tone for each of the three piles so that you may meditate on that and choose what calls to you. On pile number one, we have Mystic Merlite. On pile number two, Lemurian Calcite. On pile number three, natural, slightly smoky citrine. Now you may meditate on these piles while I play a tone for each. Okay, pile number one with our Mystic Merlinite Sphere, also known as Indigo Gabbro. We are working with the Sacred Geometry Activations and the Sacred Rebels Alana Fairchild deck. And we'll begin here with your Sacred Geometry Activation, then your Rebels Oracle cards, and I have my Elemental Oracle cards here as well if we have any clarifying questions. All right. We had coherence. It was originally in reverse, but I'm flipping it like this so you can see. The frequency of coherence supports our ability to harmonize the frequency of the heart with the frequency of the mind for an optimal ability to create the reality that we desire. So pile number ones, it seems like maybe you've been in your head. There's a disconnect between your soul passion and the thoughts that are going on in your life, and that can be creating some abundance blocks. Now we have our three Sacred Rebels Oracle cards here. Beautiful artwork. The artwork is actually done by Autumn Sky Morrison, and I love this. So beautiful. Follow your own rhythm for my number ones. What's really coming up for me with this is for the divine feminines, the uterus holders, the womb holders, anyone who has a period, really anyone, because divine masculines, people born with testicles and that anatomy, also experience hormonal rhythmic cycles. We all have seasons, and allowing ourselves to be in our season and thrive in the deepest way in that vibration, instead of forcing it to be different, is a really powerful way to be. Be authentically you March to the beat of your own drum. Create your own unique contribution. Ah, yes, again, with the authenticity theme, seeing the true you. How much do you look in the mirror and feel displeased or unwilling to give yourself the love that you give to others? How can you open to your own authenticity? How can you accept and love yourself more deeply? And our last card in this pile is the shock of the new. So my pile ones, it really feels like what's been going on in your life isn't working for you anymore. Something is not resonating with your soul. And you deserve to be authentic, see yourself in your wholeness, and be true. Be. Something new and beautiful is coming into your space if you can choose into opening and being your authentic self. We're going to pull one clarifying card just to get a message on what can be done to strengthen your resolve to be in your own power and generate deep abundance in your field. Okay, slippery cards. I'm shuffling over here, the camera frame's tiny. Oh, here we go. Mountain, clarity. See how she's resting in the snow, allowing all that is to envelop her? When we come to the peak moment of clarity, often it's in states where we are resting and integrating. How much have you been integrating your life and your experiences? What can you do to create deeper integration to find that peak clarity? All right, pile ones, that's all I have. Thank you.
All right, hello, pile.
I will see you next time. We are going to start with your sacred geometry activation over here, then move to the Sacred Rebels Oracle cards. Then I have my elemental oracle cards here to ask any clarifying questions when we come to the end. All right. Oh, okay, so we have belief inverted. I'm gonna flip it here so you can see it better. But belief, the frequency of belief supports our sense of self-worth based on our gifts and talents and a strong connection of source. So you've got belief inverted. Pile twos, have you been doubting in your divine worth? Do you struggle with your self-worth? Because that's what really comes up with this inverted belief card. You've been blocking yourself from receiving your own gifts by repeating the negative thought patterns that build poor self-worth. So let's see what else comes up here. Got these beautiful Sacred Rebels cards. Focus on the light. Yeah, this comes up a lot for me with my own journey of rewriting my thought patterns. I have had so many negative thoughts and negative self-talk, and it's taken me a lot of work to consciously choose to focus on the light and focus on what brings me joy, creates gratitude in my life, creates peace in my being. Because by choosing those thoughts over and over and over again, I am creating a new way of being. Where my attention goes, energy flows. So focus on the light. How can you be grateful for what you have in your life? Be the hunter, not the hunted. How have you been victimizing yourself, pile two? How have you been holding yourself in a narrative that you are not good enough or not strong enough? Why keep putting yourself down? How can you choose to step into your wisdom and be the hunter? Be proactive. do the things for yourself that you truly deserve. This is a lot about healing your inner masculine. How can your inner masculine show up as a healthy force to do, be, and create with you internally? For women, that can be allowing yourself to do the things that feel hard and scary. And for men, that can be allowing yourself to do the things that take care of you. And that's a bit gender binary, but ultimately the masculine energy is about, what can I do? How can I act in the world? The penetrative energy of the phallus. So what can you do to be in a healed state of masculine energy, to empower your inner masculine, to support your inner feminine, to nourish yourself and be able to do in the physical world? Oh, our third card is in the world, not of the world. So this may be connected to a lot of those struggles with belief. And I feel like struggles may be an interesting word for that, but you may be a starseed. We are all starseeds on some level, but you may be connecting more deeply to a mission of remembering that this is not the only way we can be. There are other ways that we can be in this world. And there are other ways that you have been in past lifetimes, in concurrent lifetimes, in the expansive multiverse. So learning how to ground yourself and be in the world, but not of the world. Do not let the world create you. Create your own world by exuding a vibration of pure confidence, like the salmon swimming up the river. They know their path, they know their course, even if they don't know exactly why they are swimming upstream. I don't know what salmon think. But ultimately, their inner knowing guides them to a purpose and guides them on a path. Focus on your own light that's within you and how to guide with your own leadership. You get to be the leader of your own life now, pile number two. I feel like there's a lot we could go deeper on here. Alrighty. Shuffling sounds because my frame is long. Alright, and pile number two, your elemental oracle says, building atoms. The smallest particles of existence are atoms. There are subatomic particles, but ultimately, the individual atoms interweave to create the fabric of what we are. How are the atoms of your life connecting? Where are the building blocks to create your new dream? This also brings up a lot of energy of starting from scratch. I'm gonna pull one more card. The equator, to make equal. How do you feel about the balance in your life? Is there too much work, too much play, too little? See here, the shadow self is giving a guiding hand to the light. Much in the same way that our wounds teach us deep lessons. So pile number two, it seems like you deserve to go back to some deep wounds, potentially early childhood, and really dig into, what was I learning from that moment? What can I let go that is no longer serving me? Because our bodies keep the score. Our nervous system will hold on to the electrical charge and discharge it over and over again, repeating the chemical process of trauma, basically making us relive it over and over until we clear the system. There are a lot of ways that you can do this. I highly recommend things like tapping and meditation. But pile two, it looks like you get to do some shadow work digging with this next full moon and to really get in touch with all sides of yourself, to see the shadow and focus on the light, to learn from the wounds and no longer be the victim. Thank you, pile number two. I appreciate you.
Welcome to your reading, pile number three.
Well, there's my knees. We're going to begin with your sacred geometry activation, then move to your sacred rebels oracle cards. And I have my elemental oracle cards here for clarification at the end. Let's begin. Tantric journey, upright. The frequency of tantric journey helps us to unlock the hidden knowledge and wisdom that we intrinsically hold about how to reach a state of wholeness and completion through our sensual experiences with ourselves and with another. I love that this has the Merkaba here. If you don't know much about the Merkaba, and even if you do, I'm going to remind you. The Merkaba is a fusion of the divine masculine and the divine feminine energies. It's our light body. These are two rotating pyramids of energy that swirl and generate our life force. It's a magical thing. The tantric journey is really about accessing more and more of our light body and being able to do that with another, if you so choose. Sensual energy and sacral energy with this orange color has a lot to do with both sexuality and creativity. A healthy sexual life often relates to a abundant life. I've been seeing this theme come up a lot in manifestation magic, self-love magic, and the world in general. We can manifest our abundance through healing ourselves in a sensual manner. So pile number three, here are your sacred rebels oracle cards. What do you feel? Here we have this card of a woman staring at the earth and holding an apple and an orange, sort of. She is levitating them above her hands. But what comes up from this card is, what do you feel? Especially literally with the tantric journey. How can you connect deeper to your own feelings and sensations? How can you connect to what you feel? Have you been calling apples oranges, or do you know an orange from an apple? This is a bit adult, but it comes to the concept of sensual pleasure in Tantra. Have you been faking orgasms? Because that serves no one, ultimately. How do you feel? What do you feel? How can you communicate that with your partner and with yourself? Sacred Fool. The Sacred Fool is a beautiful archetype. Here, she is scantily clad and playing with a marionette doll. But the archetype of the Sacred Fool is about learning through making mistakes, learning through being absurdly strange and odd and different and new. The concept of the Sacred Fool is sometimes considered very irreverent. It's not about doing it the right way or following the rules. The Sacred Fool creates their own path and often triggers others into learning through their antics, because the way they live is disruptive, not in a negative sense, some people will treat the sacred fool archetype very negatively, but in a very positive sense, it stirs up things inside us. The sacred fool is an awakening force of remembering play and remembering pleasure and remembering that we know what serves us. A final note on this sacred fool. The sacred fool brings levity to situations that are often serious, often taboo. So maybe you've struggled with your sexuality. Maybe you've struggled with being open with yourself or your partners. Maybe you don't masturbate. Maybe you don't engage in physical practices of self-love because of paradigms that have made you feel like your body is dirty or bad, or certain actions are dirty or bad. There are healthy ways to engage with our sensuality and our sexuality. And the sacred fool is about making a mess of the rules. So don't be afraid to break a few. Inner trust. Our final card here from the Sacred Rebels deck is inner trust. You know what works for you. Your intuition is one of the highest forces in the world. You are a powerful divine light being having a human experience. And developing a relationship with your own inner knowing and learning to trust yourself can create unimaginable depth in your life. So here, with all of this laid out, I see the next steps coming up with your abundance in this full moon being healing through sexuality and sensuality with yourself and potentially with a partner if that's something that calls to you. We're going to shuffle, shuffle, shuffle. Outer core, fluidity. This is a beautiful image, and it's all about water and sensuality. Venus energy very much here. The outer core relates to the part of the light body that connects to the world beyond us, the world beyond our physical body, beyond our own light body, how we integrate with others. So potentially, it even refers to the skin in this situation and learning to love your skin. Yeah, skin is coming up a lot in this moment. So learning to love your skin and potentially treating your skin with love and compassion through creating a skincare regimen that is more consistent than you have done in the past. And I'm pulling the second card to get a little more clarity. Storms. Cleansing. Ah, yes. Okay. That brings it all together. We here have inner trust, outer core, sacred fool. What do you feel? And storms. Cleansing. A lot of water in this theme. How can you create sacred space for yourself and feel like your energy is clear? This may be from a past trauma in your life. I know that I personally have experienced feeling like I can't get someone's energy off of me or away from my life. And so cleansing my own energy and clearing those forces from those traumas allowed me to deepen my relationship to sexuality. And I feel that could be coming up for you in this reading, pile three. So this tantric journey could be very personal. It could be about healing a relationship with your body or a relationship that you had with another person involving your body, and learning that you are sovereign. Your boundaries deserve respect. You deserve to feel clean and radiant and sexual and magical. And I'm going to pull one more card. Comfort, hearth. Yeah, this is really, oh, and we, a number 11. We've got lots of 11, 11, 11. I'm really feeling like this could be potentially a coming back to feeling safe and comfortable in your own body, pile three, and you deserve it. We all deserve to feel secure and comfortable and loved in our own bodies. You deserve to be able to feel as comfy and happy as this baby laying on that dog. Because that looks amazing. Yeah, my last thing for you today, pile three, is you are loved, you are worthy. This is a healing journey for a reason. It doesn't happen instantly. But I know you can create what you deserve in your own life. You are powerful. And thank you for being here today. I will see you next time.